Did you know that you can create your own color presets in Adobe Premiere Rush? Well, stick around because I'm going to show you how. What's up everyone, Claudio here, and thank you for stopping by to check out this next video. If this is your first time visiting, thank you so much. Every Tuesday, I add a new video here. I show people how to improve their photography skills, their video skills, and all other sorts of tech gear review. If you want to see more videos just like this one, consider subscribing to the channel by clicking on the subscribe icon, and don't forget to turn on notifications. As I mentioned at the beginning, I'm going to show you step-by-step, really quick, easy way for you to create your own color presets. Now, Adobe Premiere Rush already comes with a plethora of presets that you can just click and add to your clips and be done with it. But if you want to kind of customize, I'm going to show you how. All the footage that I'm going to be editing, I shot using the B-Script Pro here along with the S10. So I'm going to be color correcting that footage within the app itself. If you want to learn more about the B-Script Pro, I'll have a link up here at the top so you can check it out. I also have a discounted link below in case you want to pick one up, and any of the proceeds will help support this channel. So I appreciate it very much. I'm going to go ahead and launch Premiere Rush and show you up here on screen what I am doing here. I added the clips ahead of time to speed up the process. This video here I shot using an app called Filmic Pro. There are different color profiles, dynamic, flat, and log. I shot this in log profile, so that way when I brought it in here, I'm able to color correct it and gives me a little more control over all the different colors. So down here at the bottom, if you scroll through the different menus, you have the button there called color. Now, as I mentioned earlier, there's the different presets already here. So if I were to tap on different ones, I can already see a difference on the video there at the top. Now, I'm only able to do one at a time. So let's see, if I wanted to shoot, if I wanted to change it to black and white, just choose the mono there, go back to none. And let's say I want cinematic. So that's kind of looks pretty cool there, but I want to kind of change it up a bit. So if you look at the bottom, you have intensity, you have exposure, contrast, pretty much everything set to zero based on that preset there. Now, if I wanted to, let's see, I'm going to go to temperature here and kind of over color it there, kind of make it almost post-apocalyptic there. I think I kind of want that. So let me go to tint, give it a little bit of a green tint there, maybe. Let's go to shadows, bring the shadows down or up. Let's bring them down. So you can kind of get the idea. You go through here and slide these right or left based on what you want. Let's see, contrast. High contrast, let's bring it down. Maybe bring the exposure slightly up a bit. And then let's see over here, whoops, let's turn. Let's go sharpen maybe, sharpen it some. So again, go through here and pick the ones you want. Let's look at faded, see what that does. That's too much. I'm going to go back. So let's say I'm happy with this. So then what I do is on the far right, there's an options button there, and I can create a preset here. So I'm going to call this post a paw, you know, there we go. Thank you for spell check help there. Hit save. Now, if I go to my next clip, now it's reversed back to the original imported file. So what I do here is just go back to color, come on down here to my presets here. As you can see, I have several ones already created. Tap on post-apocalyptic, boom. And let's go ahead and do that to every single one of these clips. And that in a nutshell is how easy it is to create a preset in Adobe Premiere Rush. Kind of the tip is if you look at the presets that already come built in, if you see one you like, tweak it a little bit, then go and create your own custom preset. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and show you the final version of this post-apocalyptic park scene. So here we go, check it out. And that's how easy it is to create your own custom color presets in Adobe Premiere Rush. Let me know what you thought about this video. Leave me any questions or comments in the comment section below. And if you learned something new or just like this video, hit that like button. If this video was helpful and want to see more just like it, consider subscribing to the channel by subscribing to the icon you see over here on the left and turning on notifications so you don't miss anything. Thank you again for stopping by and watching this video. Be good to one another. Peace. I'm out.